We're back with the CEO and CIO of ARK Invest, which has $11 billion in assets under management. It's Cathie Wood. So we've covered Tesla. Now we get to dig into ARK's big ideas for 2020. And you have 11 big ideas. One that I found interesting is a big idea was streaming media. Because I think, isn't that an idea from 2019?
Yeah.
A big idea. What is the future that has you so excited about streaming media?
Well, we think the market's going to quadruple in 4 years. And so that's not only video, especially now that Netflix has company with Apple and Disney and others, but also music. Music has gone through 20 years of declining sales and has just turned around recently. And we think digital is going to make that really happen, get a lot more innovation there. But the most important one actually is gaming. And what we've seen, the different, now each of these we think is going to generate 35% compound annual rate of growth roughly over the next 5 years. So good, really good growth. If you look at the three though, video, music, and gaming, there's a big difference when it comes to gaming. Every new technology, or every new generation of technology has been additive to the gaming sector. Whereas in music, the new generation's destroyed it, right? And video, it's kind of been status quo. We think cloud-based gaming is the next big wave. It's 0.2% of gaming right now. We think it will be 6.3%, roughly, of gaming in 5 years. That's 120% compound annual rate of growth. And you've seen Twitch, the user growth there, 37% per year. I think today Amazon said it would start providing the Twitch platform for other gaming companies to use. Right. So we really think that's going to push gaming along and also help Amazon's AWS as well.
And you know, we touched on it when we talked about Tesla and their autonomous network, but obviously autonomous ride-hailing is another area that you guys are looking at. And the big players that we think of, they're not autonomous. Regular ride-hailing would be Uber and Lyft. And as you see that market maturing, I mean, the market really liked what Uber said last night. Do you think there's more players coming in? How do you see that whole industry playing out? Because right now, the autonomous side of it is really just buried in the R&D budgets of these companies.
Yes. We don't think Uber and Lyft are the winners in this space. We know many people do. The reason is they haven't been collecting data from their drivers' cars all these years. They could have. They could have more data than Tesla does. Mm-hmm. Tesla has 14 billion miles worth of data. They have, if they're lucky, 10 million miles. And I don't even think it's that. Google has 20 million miles. So no, we don't. Actually, we think their model is going to be harmed tremendously by autonomous. Right now, their take rate from the drivers is roughly 20 to 25%, and actually moving up a little bit. We think they will be nothing but lead generators as we move into autonomous, and lead generators tend to generate or have a take rate of 1 to 5%. Yeah. So this is going to crush their model from that point of view.
And I'm just kind of curious, you know, you mentioned the take rate, and it sounds like a very Wall Street metric, right? It's a very kind of boring metric of like, oh, we're going to increase take rate by, you know, 100 basis points and everyone goes home happy. Yeah. Were these companies, I guess they didn't have a choice but to be venture funded, but when you look at the way venture funded companies have behaved on the public market, was that model not as, did it not incubate companies that were as strong as a company like Tesla that was, you know, bootstrapped in its own way and, you know, almost went out of business 10, 12 years ago? Does that venture model maybe not create the most durable companies once they become public?
I think one problem is they stayed private too long and the venture capitalists were, you know, planning for that liquidity event and you know, dressing things up to make it a good liquidity event. They weren't thinking autonomous. They should have been. And so they say they were, but they weren't doing what they needed to do in order to catapult those companies into the pole position to take that market. So they haven't collected the data. The cars aren't their own anyway. Right. They'd have to almost pay the drivers to put sensors on their cars and so forth. So it'd be very difficult for them to move into this market.
All right. What about blockchain, cryptocurrencies? Yes. Any of this fit into your picture for the next 4 or 5 years, or just, you know, your outlook for the next year?
Yes. Well, from the peak in December of 2017 of roughly 20,000 Bitcoin dropped to 3,000 early last year and now is close to 10,000 again. During that time period, our confidence in Bitcoin as a cryptocurrency increased dramatically. And that's because its share of all of the crypto assets' network value out there, so the more than, I think, 2,500 of them, moved from the low 30% range to roughly 70%. That is the behavior of a reserve currency. So we believe Bitcoin is the reserve currency of the crypto asset world. And we have very high expectations for it as a store of value, so digital gold. Would not be surprised. It's encroaching on $200 billion in network value. Mm-hmm. We wouldn't be surprised to see that go to $3 trillion in the next 5 years. And just as a store of value and as a hedge against confiscation of wealth. Confiscation of wealth can take place in a number of ways. Inflation is one of them. Think Venezuela, Argentina. And then there's outright confiscation of wealth. Think Saudi Arabia. I'll bet those princes wished they had remembered their private key numbers or even had them so that they could walk into another country and retrieve their wealth. So I think that those kinds of episodes are getting people thinking about what this really is.
Do you have a long-term price target on
just
Bitcoin?
Back of the envelope, I'm thinking 120,000 based on what you said.
You know, the use cases to get to $3 trillion. We can get there easily from emerging markets trying to protect themselves, or people in emerging markets trying to protect themselves from inflationary policies, and as a store of value. So digital gold, generally taking maybe 15% share of the gold market, and then as a hedge against the outright confiscation of wealth. If there's a 5% probability that a person with an investable net worth of $1 million is going to have his or her wealth confiscated during his or her lifetime, well, the hedge on that would be something like Bitcoin. And we're starting to see these use cases being played out.
Does 120,000 seem high?
It doesn't to us, but we've got a long-term point of view on this, and we can see the use cases clearly. And if anything, what we've seen are monetary policies getting more and more unstable in the world. This is a big hedge against that.
So ARK's big ideas, you've got deep learning, automation, 3D printing, aerial drones.
That. I wanted to do 3D printing.
So
We don't have time. We discussed it in our meeting. Cathie can be quick.
All right. Well, I was going to say aerial drones or 3D printing, but Miles is voting for 3D printing. Can we do it quickly? 3D printing had such an exciting year a couple years ago. You look at the charts on a bunch of them, those stocks, people were all in.
It was the consumer hype.
The hype was
we're all going to have a 3D printer on our desks.
Yeah.
That was wrong. And all of the companies, including Stratasys, our largest exposure, got that wrong. They bought MakerBot right at the peak.
Yep.
Very bad idea. Restructuring. What we're seeing, though, the killer app is not the consumer. It's aerospace and medical. 95% of all hearing aids are 3D printed today. You're going to see it with braces and the clear lines, that sort of thing. But in aerospace, engines, the 3D number of 3D printed parts have gone up 15-fold, roughly, from 30 to roughly 500 in the last 5 years. We think that's going to happen again in the next 5 years. And it is going to move the needle for these companies because they have fully restructured. Now, I can tell you, we've been aggressively patient with some of these stocks. And so they've based for a very long time, just like Tesla did, based for 5 years. When there's a very long base like that, bulls and bears duking it out, the breakout or the breakdown tends to be magnificent. And we believe there's going to be a breakout.
Cathie Wood of ARK Invest, great to have you back. Hope to see you again soon.
Hey, investors, Zach Guzman here. Are you interested in learning more about the markets and getting the latest financial news? Well, then click right here to subscribe to our Yahoo Finance YouTube channel. Get the latest up-to-the-minute market analysis, big interviews in the world of finance, and information on how to manage your money every day, wherever you are.